Hello, this is Eric, the Cocos Evangelist. The last video introduced how to play the jump animation when the character is moving and how to upgrade the runway. Today I'll follow up to add the state logic for the game. Generally, we divide the game into three states. The first one is the initialization state. This state displays the game menu and initializes some assets. The second one is the game in progress state. When the game is in progress, the menu should be hidden, so that the player can start the game and control the character. The last one is the game over state. When the game is over, the end menu will appear to stop the player from controlling the character. Next, let's do the initialization part. The main task is to create a game menu. Every game has a menu, which shows buttons like Continue, New Game, Settings, etc. These are all made with UI. Next, let's create the UI. The UI of Mind Your Step includes the game tips and start button. Since we're gonna make the UI, we should switch to 2D view. In Cocos Creator 3.0, all UIs must be placed under the canvas node. So right-click in the hierarchy panel and select Create UI Component Canvas. There is a canvas component on the canvas node, which is mainly used for UI multi-resolution adaption. What is UI multi-resolution adaption? You know, the UI we created needs to be presented on different devices, and that's why we need a solution like this. Open the project settings. In project data, you can find the design width and design height. The width and height here are synchronized with the width and height on the canvas, which is 960x640 by default. You can also design your own resolution here. For example, I changed the width to 1280. You can see that the width of the canvas has changed simultaneously. Okay, restore it to 960. And the fit width and fit height below are two different resolution adaption solutions. If fit width is checked, it means that the current design resolution is adapted to different devices by adapting the width. When the design resolution aspect ratio is greater than the screen resolution aspect ratio, it's recommended to check fit height to avoid black bars. When the design resolution aspect ratio is smaller than the screen resolution aspect ratio, it's recommended to check fit width to avoid black bars. Sometimes it is required to display all content regardless of the screen aspect ratio, and black bars are acceptable. In this case, you can check both fit width and fit height. The UI of our game is very simple, so we can just use the default settings. After creating the canvas, next, create a background. Select the canvas node. Right-click to create. You can find the UI elements in two menus. One is 2D object. Another is UI component. Everything in 2D object is related to rendering, including sprite, label, mask, etc. UI components are more about user interaction and UI adaption, such as button and slider that require user action. Layout that can automatically arrange layouts, and widget that can help UI elements adapt quickly. And the background is a sprite element. The most essential difference between sprite and the normal image is that it has the 9 slicing feature. Select sprite and name the background as BG. We can see that the background is too small. Let's scale it up a bit to about 500x400. Looks okay. But the image is not what we want. So let's replace the background image. Locate its location. We can use a pure white image, like this one, default panel. Drag it to the sprite frame property to replace the original one. You'll find that the image is blurry and has 4 black corners. That's because it's a rounded rectangle, and its original size is very small. Let's see its original size. Select Raw in Size Mode. It has now been restored to its original size. It's very small, right? If we stretch it to such a large size, it will definitely be severely distorted. In this case, we can use an important feature, 9 slicing. Select the asset. Click Sprite Frame. You can see its information in the Inspector panel. Because it's a built-in asset, all properties are locked and cannot be modified. If it's your own asset, you can modify these properties. Take a look at the four main properties, border, top, bottom, left, and right, respectively. These are the nice slicing information. You can click Edit below. Zoom in. Now you can see the detail of nice slicing on this image. The main feature of nice slicing is to keep four corners and scale or repeat the rest. Okay. Next, we're gonna enable the nice slicing feature. Change the type of the sprite to sliced. And restore its size to 500x400. Then you'll find that the four black corners are gone, right? The pixel of the black corners are very small and they are not stretched at this time, so you can hardly see them. This is the nice slicing. Next, let's create a game title and the game tips. The title is a label. We can't see it now because its default color is white. We can change it to black. The title is Mind Your Step. Okay. You can modify the font size here. Since it's the title, you can adjust it to be bigger, to 40. Next, create the game tips. It's also a label. Name it tip. Left click to jump one step and right click to jump two steps. At last, create a game start button and resize it. Okay. Adjust the position. But the background looks a bit too big, right? So we also need to resize the background. This interface is actually hidden when the game starts, so we need to create a node to manage all those elements. Name it Start Menu. Drag all the elements to Start Menu to become its child node. Define the size of Start Menu, like 500x300. Looks good. So how to adapt the background to the ideal size? We can add a component called widget to the background. This component is an adaption component. The default horizontal alignment and vertical alignment are none, which means the alignment is not enabled, so we should switch the alignment mode. Set the horizontal alignment to horizontal stretching and set the vertical alignment to vertical stretching, then delete the vertical offset. Now you'll find that the background and the start menu are exactly the same size. You can also adjust the horizontal offset by 50 pixels. Now you will find the left and right size of BG are 50 pixels away from start menu. Restore it. Click PX to switch the unit to percentage. It's pixel mode by default. Okay. Pull down the game title a bit. Now, the start scene of our game is done. After finishing the UI, we need to define the game state. Open the script Game Manager. Define a state enum called GameState. This enum has three states. The first is the initialization state. The second is the game in progress state. And the third is the game over state. Similarly, we declare a variable called currentState. After having the game state, If we don't click the play button, the game won't start. So we can't control the movement of the characters. Open the script player controller. Block the event listener code. Then define a method. When the game state changes, it can notify the player controller that it can accept user actions. It receives a parameter active, which is of Boolean type. It can tell us if we can listen to the mouse up event. In other words, to receive the user actions. According to the active state. If active is true, the event will be listened. Otherwise, listening will be cancelled. In other words, when the game starts, in the game in progress state, the mouse up event will be listened and user actions will be received. When the game is over, the event listener will be cancelled, so user actions will no longer be received. Save. Okay, after we finish this method, it should be called somewhere. Also, in Game Manager, define a property player controller. You can see from above that player controller is imported. Define a play control. Then define another property start menu, which is used to hide or active the start menu node when the game state is switched. Okay. Link them to Game Manager. Oops, the prefab is lost. Drag it back. Play control. Start menu. Save the scene first to avoid data loss. Now we have completed the preliminary work of writing the game logic code. In the next video, I'll continue to talk about the game logic. See you in the next video, and please remember to subscribe.